Hello. It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance. You can call me Oscar. I was brought here to the realms of the entity to provide some much needed counseling to those like yourself who absolutely enjoy taking on the role or playing the role of the killer and killing survivors. You see, I had a practice of my own back on. It's also foggy now, but from wherever I was originally from, I served as a therapist and a counselor to all kinds of murderers and serial killers. And then one day, while I was in my office, there was a strange mist, fog, began to just envelop in my office. And I thought it was a fire at first. But then I saw these strange black tentacles or claws come out from the fog towards me and pulled me into the fog. And the next thing you know, here I am. I have my own little office here in the realm of the entity. Right down the hallway from the other gentleman, I forget his name offhand, who has a lot of recordings and tomes and lore in his vast library. But I hope you don't mind the dark ambiance here. I like to think it helps to calm the mind. But enough about me. The whole purpose of this session is all about you and helping you find some peace of mind, okay? To help relieve any stress and the like, all right? So, just a moment. What we are going to do, or what I'm going to do, is I have a notebook here just for you. I have a notebook for each and every person, being, that enjoys taking on the role of killer and who finds it quite stressful at times. So, let's see, let's go with green. I'm always using black and blue, sometimes red, for corrections. But I don't ever find myself using the green ink. So let's go with green. So I'm going to ask you, basically try to delve into your mind. Find out what it is about playing the role of the killer causes you so much stress. After all, that's why you're here. By the way, how did your last trial go? Okay. All right, so before we get into all the different reasons as to why killer role might be quite frustrating and anxiety-ridden, I want to find out a little bit about yourself, okay? So, can you just give me your name, please? Okay. Now, I understand your line of work is very stressful. Why is it that you enjoy playing the role of the killer? I see. So you seem to find it quite cathartic. All right. Do you happen to enjoy playing or taking on the role of one particular killer or killers than some others? Do you enjoy playing the role of the shape more so than Bubba? Do you enjoy playing as the dredge, becoming the dredge, and compared to the pig? Are there any killers that you enjoy becoming and enjoying killing survivors as, and then other killers not so much? Okay. All right. Okay. And do you happen to have a favorite style as to how you enjoy killing survivors? Do you go into each trial with the mindset that you just want to have fun, trying to find and kill all the different survivors, or like some others who I've met and had sessions with, that they enjoy slugging all of the survivors and watching them crawl on the ground in order to guarantee a victory? Do you enjoy camping the survivor while they are on the hook to ensure their death? How do you approach each trial when you take on the role of the killer? I see. Okay. That's enough of the preliminary background questions. That just helps me to gain a better understanding of who you are and what I'm dealing with here. Okay? So, why don't we start delving into who you are and what really makes you stressed, gives you anxiety, frustrates you to your core whenever you take on the role of the killer, okay? What's one of the things that gives you the most stress and you find the most frustrating when playing the role of the killer? Okay. Gen rushing. Now, you'll have to forgive me. I'm fairly new here. I was just brought here, well, I think it was about a week or two ago. It's funny, ever since I've been here, just memories are vague. But anyway, so this gin rushing, can you care to elaborate? Who is Jin and why are you rushing her? Oh, generator rushing. Okay. So, would you care to elaborate? So when the survivors rush to complete the generators as quickly as possible in order to escape the trial, and you find this to be a problem, the generators appear to be completed very quickly, okay? And what was that? The entity added 10 additional seconds to the generators, but yet you still feel as though they get repaired too quickly. Okay. All right. Anything else that frustrates you about playing the killer? BM. Bowel movements? Oh, my apologies. Bad manners. Okay. I'm still trying to get caught up with all the lingo. So what types of bad manners that irritate you or annoys you? I see. So you feel as though the survivors should be good sports and show professional sportsmanlike conduct while you hunt them down and kill them, even during their escape in the exit gates. They should show the utmost respect to you, the killer. Is that correct? Okay, that's completely reasonable. Okay, let's continue. Okay, so what else frustrates you and gives you undue stress when playing the role of the killer? Okay. The Survivors Rulebook. I see. Well, it just so happens, just a moment. To have the Survivor's Rulebook right here in my possession. This is the official Survivor's Rulebook, and you can see how thick it is. So let's just, I'll go through some random sections here. Let's see. We have, yes, section 4. Paragraph 14, killers are not allowed to use their powers. And let's see, section 6, paragraph 27, killers are not allowed to camp hooks. So, you find that annoying, don't you? I see. Let's see what else. Section 22, paragraph 11, killers are not allowed to use Franklin's demise. see, section 25, paragraph 3. Killers must only chase uninjured survivors. And I take it you don't agree with those rules, correct? Right? Let's see what else. Section 34, paragraph 16. Michael Myers, the shape, is not allowed to use infinite tier 3 add-ons. Section 38, paragraph 5. Trapper and Hag may not place more than one trap, and it must be placed in an obvious and visible location. See what else we have here. So many rules, so many detailed explanations for each rule. Section 74, paragraph 88. Killer is not allowed to take advantage of a survivor that made a mistake during a chase or at a loop. See what else. Section 78, paragraph 53. Killers are not allowed to find survivors within the first 2 minutes of the trial. I must say, from my professional perspective, these are quite absurd, but these are the survivor's rules every killer must follow. Section 128, paragraph 94. Killers are not allowed to tunnel survivors. You must play fair and according to the rules of the survivors at all times. It's perfectly made clear in this rule book. Section 130, paragraph 9. Killers must allow survivors to repair generators. Let's see what else. Section 310, paragraph 8. Killers are not allowed to slug survivors. Section 312, paragraph 193. Killers are not allowed to use any perks or add-ons. Let's just do a couple more here. Let's see. Flip to a random section. Getting towards the end. Section 991, paragraph 42. Killers are not allowed to complain about survivors' perks. And lastly, section 994, paragraph 11. Killer should remain in a corner for the entire duration of the trial, not doing anything, and allow survivors to escape. So, there you have it, the Survivor's Rulebook. Quite hefty. You know what? Why don't you borrow this, okay? Here you go. And that way you can study it on your free time. when you're not playing the role of the killer. And that way you can understand and study the survivor's rules and how you must play the role of the killer to ensure that the survivors have fun and enjoy themselves, okay? And maybe that will help with some of the stress, frustration that you experience, okay? All right, so Survivor's Rulebook, one of the things that you find frustrating. What else stresses you, annoys you when you take on the role of the killer? Okay. Looping. Would you care to elaborate? Okay, see. So you feel as though the survivors should only be able to run away from you in a straight line, not be able to run around a car or some junk or the killer shack like it's a cartoon. They should just run away from you, not be able to loop you, and make it easy for you to hit them and down them. Is that correct? Yes, okay. Well, that's completely acceptable. Understandable. Okay, looping. Very frustrating. Okay. What was that? Especially the survivors that know how to loop well. Okay, all right. So what else gives you heartburn, indigestion, when it comes to playing the role of the killer? I see. This teabagging at the exit gates. You don't like it when survivors enjoy some tea while they're in the exit gates and watching them dip their tea bags into their nice little teacups. That annoys you? Oh, I'm sorry. More lingo that I don't quite understand yet, but now I know. Thank you. So when they repeatedly crouch over and over and over to mock you, that really grinds your gears, dulls your blade, snaps your traps. Is that right? Okay. So you feel survivors, when they have won the trial, should just leave, show the utmost professionalism and sportsmanship, and thank you for allowing them to escape, and just walk out or run out the exit gates. Is that correct? Okay. Again, it seems reasonable. Let's make a note here. So what else frustrates you when playing the role of the killer? Okay. You miss or confuse you because you have such a limited vision, and they're able to spin around and go a different direction while you try to take a swipe with your weapon, and thus they make you miss, or they make you seem less powerful than you actually are. So that's that stresses you out and frustrates you, correct? Okay. Just so you know, when I'm done here and what I do after each session is I go through and see what some of the things are that frustrate and annoy killers such as yourself. Well, I mean, you are not a killer. You're a being that takes on the role of a particular killer. Do you sometimes take on the role of a survivor? I see. Okay. All right. But anyway, as I was saying, I go review my notes from each session that I've spent with various individuals who enjoy playing the role of the killer, find out what frustrates them the most, and then once a month, I meet with the entity, and we discuss these matters. So maybe, you know, at some point in the future, the entity will address things such as looping. Maybe one day the entity will take looping out of the game and 360 tech, things like this, okay? So cross your fingers. In the meantime, all right? Okay, so what else frustrates you as when you play the role of the killer? Hackers. Okay, why do hackers? What are these hackers? Ah, I see. So there are some individuals who have learned how to manipulate the inner workings of the realms to their advantage and are able to, what are they able to do? So sometimes they're able to equip more than 4 perks, I see, and various other things. Okay. Just make a note of that. Hackers frustrate you. Okay. Okay, so again, I'll pass that. I'll have a conversation with the entity. See if they can do anything about these hackers. Okay. All right, so what else frustrates you when playing the role of a killer? Flashlights. Okay. So how do flashlights bother you? Just a moment. I happen to have a flashlight right here. So what is it about the flashlight that bothers you so much? When survivors click their flashlight repeatedly at you, why is that? To bait you? To mock you? I see. Okay, so this sound. That gives you PTSD. Okay. Well, there are few ways to gain power over this. First and obvious is to equip the perk Lightborn. Now, I have recently started playing the killer myself, and whenever I see survivors waiting to start the trial, and one or more of them has a flashlight in their hand, well, I swap a perk out for Lightborn. So that, I find that helps me. So maybe that's something you should do more often. It's a truly wonderful ability, power to have. Lightborn, you never get blinded at pallets. You don't have to worry about trying to find any survivors that might be hiding when you go to pick up a survivor and they try to blind you to make you drop that survivor, etc. So here, see, it's just a flashlight. It can't hurt you. Here, once you take that, hold on to it, okay? It's okay. It's all right. There you go. Just, yeah, you see? It's just a metal object. It has no power over you. So you just need to change the way you think about, don't be afraid of the flashlight, okay? The flashlight cannot hurt you, okay? What's that? You feel like you're getting eye cancer from the flashlight, having been blinded by flashlights so much? Okay, well, maybe you should meet with the resident, the doctor. Maybe he can provide you with treatment, okay? Help give you some new eyes. But you hold on to that flashlight. Take it with you, all right? And until you realize you, the killer, are the one to be feared, don't fear the flashlight, okay? Right. So, let's continue. I think we're making great progress. What else frustrates you when playing the role of the killer? Okay. Medkits. Toolboxes. Flashlights. And offerings. Okay. So, why is it that those items that the survivors can bring to a trial or to influence a trial and where it takes place, the realm, what is it about that, those things that gives you stress and anxiety? I see. Well, it's like psychological warfare for the survivors and for you. So when you see the survivors with four med kits, four tool kits, and then you see a map offering like Coldwind Farm, that creates anxiety within you even before the trial has started. Okay? Well, you need to not let that affect you in that way. They are still weak, puny humans. You are the killer. You are powerful. They are not, okay? So, just like that flashlight, don't let the med kits and the tool boxes or the offering to whatever map it might be. Maybe Raccoon City Police Department, when you're playing maybe Billy or the gunslinger, okay? Don't let that impact you psychologically. You still need to just maybe don't look at anything until the trial starts, okay? Just go into the trial. Perhaps it might help when you go into the trial with the mindset that it doesn't matter. These puny humans, doesn't matter if they have 20 med kits and 100 flashlights, they're not going to stop you from killing them and sacrificing them to the entity, okay? So what I'm gathering so far and what I'm starting to understand and see things a little better as a new addition to the realms of the entity myself as a therapist, I'm starting to understand that you and many others take on the role of killers, that the survivors should be the weaker of the bunch, that you are the power role, correct? They should fear you. And not just that, but they should have med kits, toolboxes, be able to loop or spin around you. They should just be able to run away in a straight line, no obstacles in your way. And they should be easily killed, downed by you, and sacrificed. And that the trial should really only take about 3 minutes tops as you kill everyone quickly. Is that correct? Okay. All right. Seems reasonable enough. Okay. So what else frustrates you, annoys you, aggravates you when playing the role of the killer? Okay. Unbalanced realms or unbalanced maps to some. Why is that cause of frustration and stress for you? I see. So you feel certain maps give the survivors an advantage. I see. Especially when you take on the role of certain killers. All right. Well, isn't it a fair statement that some of the maps for the survivors feel as though they give the killers an advantage? Mm-hmm. Yes. So it does kind of go both ways. Yeah. But again, that doesn't mean that it shouldn't be addressed. I'll speak with the entity. Try to convince them to make sure all of the realms are the same shape, maybe a different, obviously different atmosphere, different look and design, but still maintain a consistency among them so that no realm or map gives any side an advantage. Okay, all right, so what else gives you stress when playing the role of the killer? Okay. So you feel that certain killers have been neglected by the entity, that are even have had some of their powers altered to make them weaker. Is that correct? Yes, I've been hearing that as well from some of the other individuals like yourself who also enjoy playing the role of the killer. So, well, perhaps one day the entity will decide that some of these killers it has brought into its realms definitely need to be improved upon and made, in my professional opinion, all killers should be of equal strength. There should be no such thing as weaker, strong killers. The nurse, the blight, maybe Wesker, they shouldn't be the top three killers that individuals like yourself enjoy taking on the role of. All killers, Billy, Freddy, Pig, Trapper, Hag, etc., should be of equal strength. So it doesn't matter which killer survivors face, they'll all be a challenge. Okay. All right. So let's continue. I think we're on the verge of a breakthrough here. What else gives you stress when playing the role of the killer? I see. Sound of lightning strike when the survivors light the boon, especially circle of healing. Okay. And that sound also gives you PTSD. I understand. Okay. Well, unfortunately, that is a perk that the survivors are able to equip. And I've heard from other killers like yourself or other individuals who enjoy playing the role of the killer that it's also frustrating is when they light the boon in a part of the map where a generator has been repaired in a part of the realm map, same thing, a part of the realm where the trial takes place that you won't ever visit or have a need to go to, and they'll always run off there to heal. That's frustrating. Yes. Okay. Well, not much can do about that, except perhaps the entity might consider what do you call it? Nerfing. Yes. Nerfing. Circle of healing. So it's not quite as powerful. Okay. Anyway. So what else causes you aggravation and stress and anxiety? Okay. Body blocking. Would you care to elaborate? I see. So when healthy survivors, or sometimes unhealthy, injured survivors, put themselves between you and an injured survivor you're trying to down, that's frustrating. Yes, I understand. Survivors, I believe that's in the rule book too, that I'm letting you borrow. You must allow survivors to body block you. They do it when you're trying to carry a downed survivor on your shoulder to the hook. They do it when you're trying to chase an injured survivor even out of the exit gate. They'll get between you. and that one survivor you're so desperately trying to down and hook for at least one kill and sacrifice. Is that correct? Okay. All right. Well, the only thing I can say to that is when it comes to body blocking you, carrying an injured survivor, maybe equip the perk Starstruck. That's a thought. There's not much else you can really do besides whack the survivors body blocking you and just try to improve your skill so that you kill most of the sacrifice, most of the survivors, so that there aren't many left to body block you. Okay. All right. Let's continue. What else frustrates you? Okay. Gives you stress? This acronym I know. SWF. Survive with Fiends. Oh, friends, right. So, what is it about SWF that gives you stress? I see. So you feel that the SWF should never have been an option for the survivors, that the entity made a terrible mistake by allowing that. I see. So every trial should consist of four random survivors that are unable to communicate with each other. And it is the ability for four friends, survivors who are friends, to communicate with one another during a trial that gives them a clear advantage, sometimes an advantage over you. Sometimes they'll do it to deliberately annoy you, okay, right? And they have a much better advantage than for individual or solo survivors trying to survive a trial. Yes. Well, there is a school of thought, like I briefly mentioned, that thinks the survivor, the entity, should have never allowed friends or survivors that know one another to group up in such a way. Yes, I can understand that to a degree. Yeah. So, but fortunately, I don't think that's going to change. But hopefully, the entity will take strides to address that. That's all we can hope for, isn't it? Okay. Let's make some notes of that. All right, let's continue. What else irks you? What else dulls your hatchet as a killer, stresses you out? Okay. Dead Hard. Okay. I think that was a great movie, by the way. Oh, that was Die Hard. I thought that was the first perk inspired by an actual movie. But okay. Dead Hard. So what is it about this perk that frustrates you? I see. So it gives the survivors an extra unnecessary health state. Okay. And you feel it should be deleted from the available perks that survivors have. Okay. And you feel survivors abuse it because they are able to use it dead hard when trying to unhook other survivors or various other situations that make it unfair. I see. Okay. Well, that's reasonable, I think. Okay. All right. Well, again, all we can do is hope that the entity will hear what you and various other individuals who enjoy playing the role of the killer think about Deadheart. All right, so let's continue. What else gives you stress and anxiety with playing the role of the killer? I see. Okay. The meta. So how does the meta stress you out and annoy you? Okay. So you feel that survivors equip certain perks to speed up gen repair and prevent from being injured and downed. Killers then in turn equip certain perks to regress generators, and as well as perks that create insta-downs. So there's always that meta war, so to speak, I say. And you feel as a killer, if you don't run the proper meta perks, that you're going to lose. Okay? I see. Well, I can understand that to a degree. However, I will say, from some of my own experience as when playing the role of certain killers, I've enjoyed playing as the Dredge, the Hag, the Twins, who else? The Doctor, Bubba, that I don't need to camp or to slug. And many times, sometimes I'll proxy camp if I leave a hook, especially if someone unhooks a survivor before I've gotten very far away. I'll go back and chase down the person that unhooked the survivor to be sacrificed. But I play the way I play. I don't really abide by the rules, by the rule book, Survivor's rule book. But I try to hunt down and find all the different survivors and hook them. That's fun for me. Do I sometimes protect a 3-gen? Sometimes, if I'm not doing well. But I never run any meta perks. I enjoy Lightborn when needed, Iron Grasp to ensure I get to a hook while carrying a survivor without bumping into things or being affected by wiggle. And then I run whatever other 2 perks, sometimes Jolt and Scourge Hook Pain Resonance, sometimes, I don't know, things just to make my life easier, like Spirit Fury and Enduring. And I'm still able to kill anywhere from 1 to all survivors. Sure, I have my trials where everyone escapes, but I like to think my win rate is higher than 50%. So the only thing I can suggest is maybe if you need to improve upon your ability, skill as a killer, work on that. Work on your being able to predict what a survivor will do. Where you should go at the beginning of a trial. Usually the survivors spawn opposite you on the other side of the realm map. So go in that direction. And then just don't focus on preventing generators from being repaired. Try not to focus on 3-gen unless you're hag or trapper. Unfortunately, you're kind of stuck with that strategy. But just try to go into each trial. Don't focus on winning. Try to go in with the mindset of having fun. That you may lose, you probably will lose. And that way you're not setting yourself up for disappointment, okay? So, but yes, the meta, there should be no meta. All perks should be viable. None should be stronger than others, et cetera, et cetera. So, okay. So, what else gives you stress and anxiety when playing the role of the killer? Okay. Hook, saboteurs, and sabo squads. So, why does sabotaging the hook or sabo squad annoy you and frustrate you? I see. So you're trying to hook a downed survivor and someone runs up with a toolkit and sabotages the hook, forcing you to find another hook. And you may not be able to hook the survivor you're carrying in time. I see. Well, there's not much you can do about that. But I would recommend equipping iron grasp or agitation. I like iron grasp because it's not affected by wiggle or boil over. And while it may not feel as quick as agitation, with iron grasp, you have plenty of time to get to another hook if the hook you're going to gets sabotaged. So that's one of the reasons I personally always equip iron grasp and sometimes lightborn, because sometimes those sabo squads have one or two flashlights on them, and in most cases I have been able to sacrifice and kill that entire team. So that's something to think about. All right. Okay. Let's continue. We're making great progress, I say. Wouldn't you agree? All right. How are you feeling? Are you starting to feel more at ease, peace of mind? Do you feel stress and pressure being lifted off your shoulders? Starting to maybe get a better perspective on things? Okay, I hope so. Because I only wish you nothing but the best in all your future trials. And I hope that you're able to kill all the survivors in a stress-free way, that you're able to do your job without any stress, okay? So, what else irks you, frustrates you when playing the role of the killer. Okay. Missing your swings, your attacks. And hitting a random tree instead of a survivor, or hitting air. Okay. Right. Well, the only thing I can say there is to be more patient with your swings, your attacks. Sometimes the emotions during the trial get the best of us, and you're trying really hard to really land that hit instead of being patient and waiting for the right moment, okay? So that's, just try to work on that, okay? Anything else that stresses you out, playing the killer, okay? When survivors don't boop the snoot, okay, boop, snoot. Would you care to elaborate? So when you take on the role of the pig and you go into stealth mode and you crouch down, survivors won't come up and boop the snoot, your snoot. I see, okay. Well, I mean, you are very powerful killer. Everyone knows how powerful the pig is. Gives the nurse some a run for her money. But, yeah, well, they probably just fear you. That's what it is. So don't take it personally, okay? So what else stresses you out when playing the role of the killer? Okay. RNG. I've heard a couple other individuals who play the role of the killer mention this. I forget what it means. Could you? Random number generator. I see. So you don't like it when random numbers are generated. No, that's not it at all. Oh, so when you go into a trial, the god of RNG, the RNG gods, there's more than one? Okay, so the RNG gods sometimes generate more pallets than should be in the trial, or they generate back-to-back vaults, multiple windows, two in a row. I see. Okay. And that's unfair. Right. I can see that. Perhaps the entity should make it so that there should never be back-to-back or double window vaults, and that there only should be a certain maximum number of pallets per trial. Okay. Make a note of that. Okay. So, what else irritates you, annoys you, frustrates you when playing the role of the killer? Okay. Sometimes your hex totems spawn right next to survivors when they spawn right next to generators, and you said they also spawn right out in the open where it's easy to see them. I understand. So you feel that the hex totems should be more obscured, should never spawn near where survivors spawn. Shouldn't spawn right next to a generator. Okay. Perhaps should spawn somewhere not near anything. Maybe on your side of the trial when you spawn in. Okay, all right. Seems rational and reasonable. Okay. Well, my friend, if I may call you that, I know we just met, but I'm feeling a kind of kinship here between us. Maybe it's because we both enjoy playing the role of the killer. Anyway, we're winding down towards the end of our session here, but would you give me a few more examples as to what frustrates you when playing the killer? Okay. Long chases and gens popping. Care to elaborate? I see. So sometimes you feel you're spending too much time on a chase. Meanwhile, one, two, maybe three generators have popped, and you only got one, maybe two hooks. I see. Yes, that's something else other individuals that play the role of the killer have told me. Perhaps you're spending, you need to reevaluate how you approach playing the killer role. Maybe you're spending too much time on a chase. When you feel that it's been 20 seconds, maybe a little less, maybe it's time to abandon that chase and find some other survivors. Don't let your emotions take the best of you, okay? Learn to drop chase, especially if you're chasing a survivor past some other survivors who are repairing a gen. Break the chase to hit them. That's what you need to try to do, okay? So, just something you might need to work on, all right? Anything else that bothers you, frustrates you, playing the killer? Okay. Right. See. So, sometimes you feel that you're spending too much time in the beginning of the trial searching for survivors. Yes. Well, they can be quite the pesky, tricky little bunch trying to hide from you. But with practice and when knowing where to go when you spawn into the trial versus where the other survivors spawn in, you'll find that that doesn't happen quite as often. Perhaps you should try equipping some aura reading perks, like Lethal Pursuer, so that way you get accustomed to seeing and understanding where survivors will spawn at the beginning of a trial, so that you don't have to waste time, or you get more familiar and you don't have to use that perk. And if I may suggest, perhaps ignoring that far generator in the corner of the realm or map, focus on the generators that are fairly close to each other. Don't just defend them, waste time just defending that area. But don't spend your time going off to that lone far gen, and make sure you go check the generator in the middle of the map, because sometimes that can make it difficult for the killer to, when it comes down to just one generator being repaired and the survivors repaired the middle one, Then you have one generator on one side of the map and one or two on the other side. Very difficult to patrol in that scenario. Sometimes it's difficult to avoid that situation, but okay, my friend, how about one more thing? What's one more thing that frustrates you? You've told me a lot already. Some things that other individuals like yourself who play the role of the killer have also mentioned. What else frustrates you? Gives you anxiety and stress? Yes. When the hatch opens and you can't find the remaining survivor or the hatch. So you spend all that time trying to find the hatch while also trying to find the survivor. And you're having a difficult time trying to find both. And sometimes the survivor finds the hatch before you. Sometimes they'll teabag you at the hatch, correct? Yes. Well, there are no perks that allow the killer to find the hatch, unlike survivors, although they don't really use those perks either that much. There's not much you can do in that case. Some survivors will just remain hidden because they know you're going to try to close the hatch, and they'll stay hidden near one of the exit gates in order to try to open it right after you've closed the hatch. So I would suggest just trying to find the hatch as quickly as you can, close it, and then pick one of the exit gates to go to, and hopefully you'll find one of the survivors, okay? All right, well, you've given me quite a lot of information, and that will be very useful for our future sessions, and of course to my monthly discussion with the entity. Provide some of this data to the entity for them to consider making some necessary changes. All right? But most importantly, I hope by now that you've found some more peace of mind, okay? That you feel a lot of stress and burden released, you know, lifted off of your psyche and your shoulders, and that going forward, you'll approach each and every trial as though you're going to have fun. You're make sure to study the Survivor's Rulebook and then ignore everything that it says. Kill the survivors however you need to, okay? You want to camp? You want to slug? Okay, you want to play fair, however you want to. You're the killer. You don't need to play by the rules. Kill the survivors, however and in whatever manner you choose, okay? So, again, it was a pleasure to meet you. And I wish you nothing but the best and success in all your future trials, okay? Now, if you'll excuse me. some survivors that I need to kill.